Hello friends, welcome to HK Classes YouTube channel. Myself, Hari Krishna Soma. I'm a chemistry faculty. And today, I have come with one new important topic in basic concepts of chemistry. That is the concept of the limiting reagent. So as you know, while solving many stoichiometric calculations, based on the given data, this is very much useful. And for a student point of view, to solve the questions in this particular concept, first of all, the important thing that is required is you need to understand the question. And after that, frame the equation and then balance it so that you will get the stoichiometric equation, which is a completely balanced equation. So once you got it, now try to compare the coefficients of the reactants and that of the products. At the same time, you compare them maybe in terms of the moles, maybe in terms of the volumes, maybe in terms of the masses as per the requirement. So in order to understand, let me brief you how to understand the concept of the limiting reagent. So for the sake, let me take one reaction where hydrogen gas is combining with chlorine gas to give HCl. So this is a stoichiometric equation because it is completely balanced. So as per the stoichiometry, we can write it as 1 mole of the hydrogen, because coefficient of H2 is 1, is combining with 1 mole of the chlorine to give 2 moles of the HCl. Suppose students assume in the data they had given like this. So 4 moles of the hydrogen is given, 3 moles of the chlorine is given. The question is, find the number of moles of the HCl. That is the question, just assume. This is the given data or given question. Now, first of all, you need to identify what is a limiting reagent and what is excess reagent. Suppose, friend, so assume hydrogen is completely consumed. Hydrogen is completely consumed. So before that, we need to understand what is a limiting reagent and what is a excess reagent, then only we can solve the questions. Okay, now here limiting reagent is the one that is completely consumed in the reaction. So that is limiting reagent always it will be consumed completely. And the one which is remained after the reaction is generally called as excess reagent. And all these stoichiometric calculations must be done with respect to limiting reagent only. Okay. Now in these two, as per data, let us find out which is a limiting and which is a excess reagent. Okay. So here they had given 4 moles of the hydrogen and 3 moles of the chlorine. Suppose students assume 4 moles of the hydrogen is completely consumed. Just assume. That means since here every 1 mole of the hydrogen requires 1 mole of the chlorine. Okay. If we take 4 moles of the hydrogen is completely consumed, definitely we need 4 moles of this. But they are given only 3 moles of the chlorine, but not 4 moles. That means they did not give sufficient amount of the chlorine to get consumed completely with 4 moles of the hydrogen. Therefore, conclusion is that we can conclude that now here chlorine is a limiting reagent and hydrogen is excess reagent, because this is completely consumed. Just I told you, all these stoichiometric calculations must be done with respect to the limiting reagent only. So therefore, 1 mole of the chlorine as per the stoichiometry should produce 2 moles of the HCl. Okay, and how many moles is consumed completely? 3 moles. Therefore, 3 moles of Cl2 should produce 6 moles of Cl. Now you may have a doubt, sir, why hydrogen is called as excess reagent? Okay, see here, these two are in 1:1 molar ratio. That means 3 moles of the chlorine is completely reacts with 3 moles of the hydrogen. But how many moles of hydrogen is given? 4 moles. Therefore, moles of hydrogen remained or hydrogen unreacted will be 4 moles is given, 3 moles is reacted, so 1 mole is unreacted. So therefore, here this hydrogen is a excess reagent. I hope all of you understood this. Okay, so let us solve some questions here. That is question number 1. Yeah, so 10 liters of oxygen and 14 liters of hydrogen are allowed to react. Okay, the reaction mixture is cooled to room temperature. Find the composition of final mixture only vapor phase. They're asking to find out the composition of the vapor phase. Okay, so yeah, so first we need to write the balance equation. So see the data. As per the data, there is a reaction between hydrogen and oxygen. That is, so hydrogen gas combines with oxygen gas to give H2O. So reaction mixture is cooled. So hydrogen and oxygen are gases and water is a liquid. So balance this equation here. So 2 moles of hydrogen combines with 1 mole of the oxygen to give 2 moles. So as per the stoichiometry, we can write here 2 moles of this is combining with 1 mole of the oxygen to give 2 moles of the water. Okay, now we can convert this into volume also, because as per the Gay-Lussac law, we can convert the moles of the gas into volumes directly. So therefore, this will be 2 liters of hydrogen combines with 1 liter of the oxygen, so it is a liquid. Now check the data here. 10 liters of the oxygen is given, 14 liters of the hydrogen is given. That means they had given this as 14 liters, this has 10 liters. Okay. That means if I say 14 liters of this hydrogen is completely consumed, half of the 14 of that of oxygen is required. That means the amount of oxygen is required is only 7 liters, but we have 10 liters here. So finally, we can conclude that this is a limiting reagent. This is a excess reagent. Therefore, what is consumed completely here? Hydrogen. Therefore, amount of hydrogen remained will be 0. And volume of oxygen remained will be or unreacted. This is equal to 10 liters is given, 7 liters is consumed, 3 liters of oxygen is remained after the reaction. So the gas which is remained is only oxygen. By how much volume is? That is 3 liters. I hope you understood this, friends. So let us go for one more question. I have increased difficulty to some extent in this question. Okay, so let us solve this question also. First one, yeah, see the question here. Mass of the magnesium nitride Mg3N2 produced when 48 grams of the magnesium is treated with 34 grams of the ammonia. So it is a reaction between magnesium as well as the ammonia. So let us write the equation first. That is, magnesium is a solid metal and ammonia is a gas. So already they are given, the product formed is Mg3N2, but we need to balance the totally Mg3N2 along with, definitely we should get hydrogen gas. Hydrogen gas. Now we need to balance this. So in this balanced, we have 3 magnesiums here. That means we need 3 gram atoms of magnesium. We have 2 nitrogens here. That means we'll take 2 moles of the ammonia, and 3 to the 6 means we will get 3 moles of the hydrogen gas. This is the stoichiometric balanced equation. Now, how to solve this question as per the given data? That means first we need to find out the what is a limiting and what is excess reagent. Okay, so before that, so 3 gram atoms of magnesium means 3 into 24 is atomic weight of the magnesium, which will get 72 grams of the magnesium is combining with as per the stoichiometry, and 2 into 17 grams, that is 34 grams of the ammonia is reacting. Now Mg3N2, this will be 3 into 24 plus 2 into 14. We will get 100 grams of this, and 3 into 2, 6 grams of the hydrogen. But as per the question, they're asking to find out only this. Only this. So now let us find out which is a limiting and which is excess reagent. To see the data or stoichiometric comparison here, 72 grams of the magnesium is combining with 34 grams of the ammonia. Now see the question here, they had given 48 grams of the magnesium and 34 grams of the ammonia. So ammonia is required is 34 grams, that 34 given, but magnesium required is 72 grams, but they are given only 48 grams. That means in this, we can conclude, or can we conclude the magnesium as the limiting reagent, students? Because required is 72 grams. They are given only 48 grams. Yes, no doubt. The magnesium is a limiting reagent. Ammonia is a excess reagent. So we have to do the calculation based on what? The limiting reagent only. Therefore, if I take here, 72 grams of magnesium is able to produce 100 grams of the Mg3N2. But how much is given magnesium? Only 48 grams is given. So 48 grams of magnesium should produce how many grams of the product? So make it as X. So therefore, this X is equal to 100 into 48 divided by 72. You will get 200 divided by 3 is the answer. It will be option number 4. Yes, friends. So I hope all of you understood this. So please do like this as well as share this to your friends. Okay, so tell them to subscribe as well as please try to share this to as many learners as possible. So thank you very much, friends.